Hey there guys, what's happening and welcome back to the channel. My name's Mike Davison and I'm a property consultant here in Phuket, Thailand. And in this video, I'm going to be talking all about how expats make money here in Phuket. So if you are thinking about making the move to Phuket and you're looking for different ways to earn an income, then this video is going to be super helpful for you. So without further ado, let's dive straight in. So these type of videos always seem to do really, really well. Videos about earning an income in Thailand. And I'm guessing the reason is that, like me, so many people visit Thailand for the first time, they fall in love with the place, and they want to live here permanently. And it's completely possible. There are thousands, hundreds of thousands of expats living in Thailand who are earning an income. But it's really important to do your research before you get here. Don't just show up and expect that you're going to be able to walk into a 7-Eleven or a coffee shop and get a job. It's really not as simple as that. So well done for doing your research, and let's dive in to five different ways to earn an income specifically here in Phuket. And we'll start with what is definitely the most popular one these days. It's changed from 10 years ago, obviously, but these days there are so many people that you meet here in Phuket who are earning online. Either have got their own online businesses, they're working for an online job, they're working for a company. I know a guy down the road from me, he works online for an insurance company in Australia. I know another guy who works for a pest control company in Australia doing admin. So there's all sorts of different online opportunities which would allow you to effectively earn Western money and live in Phuket, which is the dream scenario, right? You're going to live a very, very nice life. Now, obviously, there's hundreds of different ways to earn online. I used to do it myself. I used to have a successful affiliate marketing business. I still do some digital marketing projects for private clients, but it's an excellent way to sustain your life here in Phuket. Now, the new visa regulations, the new destination tourist visa, or the DTV, makes it 100% legal and above board to work online here in Thailand. Previously, it was a little bit tricky working online. You had a lot of the digital nomads who were doing education visas to get the visa requirements and working on the side. But nowadays, the new destination tourist visa allows you to work online as a freelancer and various other different professions 100% legally. So we expect that in the next few years, there are going to be, or next few months even, there's going to be a big influx of digital nomads coming to work here in Thailand. Now, the DTV, the destination tourist visa, allows you to stay here for 5 years, which is absolutely incredible. If you do want info on that, guys, we can assist you in processing it. Just drop me a message, or my links are on the screen now. All right, so that's the first one, working online. Let's talk about the second one, which is teaching. Now, this is something I've also done. I worked as a teacher for 6-7 years here in Phuket before I got into the real estate industry. And it's not going to make you $1 million, but it's a great way to get your foot in the door. It's a great way to make connections. The salary in the government schools isn't great. You know, you're talking 40,000, 45,000 baht a month. It's enough to live, just about. But if you get into an international school, which is where I was working, you can actually make fairly good money. There was a point when I was head of department at a big international school here, and I was doing all right. It was a pretty cushy job, but then I decided to leave to get into the real estate side of things. So if you are looking for teaching jobs here in Phuket, there's a great website called ajahn.com. I'll put the link in the description to this video. The international schools tend to advertise on the Times Education Supplement, or TES.com. Again, I'll put the links in the description. So teaching is a good one. I didn't want to do it for much longer. I did have my reasons, but we won't go into them now. But if you are looking to find work, like I said, those two websites that I recommended, they have lots of job listings on. All right, so let's get on to job number three, which is working in the real estate industry. Now, as you probably know, if you follow this channel, the real estate industry here in Phuket is booming. There are a lot of new projects, a lot of resales on the market, a lot of new agents, and there are lots and lots of different jobs that you can find in the property industry as a foreigner, not just working as an agent, but I know a lot of people, myself included, who work in the marketing side of property. I know a lot of people who do staged houses and specialize in setting up open houses. I know a few people who are real estate photographers. So the real estate industry as a whole has a lot of different opportunities for foreigners here. So if you are looking for real estate work in Thailand, I would recommend LinkedIn. If you type in real estate agent Phuket, you'll see there's quite often jobs from real estate agencies, also from developers directly as well, who are looking for English speaking people to work on their team. They are also often looking for Russian and Chinese speaking people. So if you can speak Russian, English, and Chinese, well, you're onto something there. You will most likely find a job, particularly if you've got sales experience. So the real estate industry is a great industry to work in. It's very competitive now. There are a lot more agents than there used to be, but there is certainly a lot of opportunity here. There's some great projects. There's also some pretty sketchy projects, speaking completely frankly. So you have to know what you're doing if you're gonna look after your clients the best way. So if you are interested in looking for property work, feel free to drop me a message. We sometimes recruit new experienced agents, or you can check out LinkedIn, like I said before. All right, so that's number three, the property side of things. Let's talk about number four, which is opening your own business. Now, over the years living here in Phuket, I've seen a lot of people launch businesses, some successful, some not so successful. And there are a wide range of different businesses that foreigners get into. Probably one of the most popular and one of the easiest and lowest barriers to entry would be starting a restaurant, a cafe or a bar, or even nowadays you get a lot of foreigners who are starting weed shops as well. Now, the bar side of things and the restaurant side of things, it's very, very seasonal, okay? So high season, a lot of my friends who have restaurants and bars in the coastal towns like Patong and Qatar and Caron, they do very, very well in the high season. But now it's October, it's mid-October now, it's pretty quiet. They don't have a lot of customers going through the doors. Now here in Katu, where it's more of an expat market, my friends who've got bars and restaurants here, they do okay, you know, but they seem to be chained to the bar or the restaurant all the time, unless they've got a very, very good manager in there who they can trust. Now, it does come with some pitfalls, obviously. I've seen a lot of people open bars here and just drink their profits, you know. HR can be pretty tricky if you're trying to recruit people to work in your bar. Finding good, reliable, trustworthy staff is not simple here in Phuket, so I'm told. I've never opened a bar myself, and I certainly wouldn't want to, but anyway, it is an option that a lot of people do. Some people do it very successfully, and obviously, some people don't. So that's the fourth one, starting your own bar or restaurant. And onto the final one today, which is again something that quite a few of my friends do, which is working as a dive instructor. Now this might sound like a great job, going out on the boats every day, swimming, diving in the sea around the Phi Phi Islands, around Phuket, but again, it's very, very seasonal. I know that a lot of my friends, they're busy every single day through high season, and then in low season, they're sitting twiddling their thumbs. A lot of them go home to work during low season to make some extra money in their home country. Then they come back for high season to make the most of it. Now, I've never dived in my life, actually, but a couple of my friends, they do work as dive instructors, and they absolutely love it. They think it's great. So if you are looking for work as a dive instructor, I would recommend you get yourself over here and you meet the diving community. There's certain places around Shalong that they hang out. You want to network with them, and if you've got your PADI certificates and things, bring over a CV handed out, and that's probably the best way to find diving work here in Phuket. So there you have it, guys. 5 different ways to earn an income as an expat here in Phuket, Thailand. Hopefully you found this useful. Hopefully it gave you some ideas. If you would like to connect with me and other expats and digital nomads here in Phuket, I'm gonna leave a link to a couple of Facebook groups in the description to this video. Thailand Expats and Digital Nomads and Phuket Living, which is a brand new Facebook group all about living in Phuket. With that said, thanks for watching, and as always, I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.